Audio Jungle.
The F-Series pickup trucks are Ford's golden goose, having just marked an incredible 42 straight years as the top-selling pickup in the United States and the 37th year as the best-selling vehicle of any kind. It's a remarkable streak for one of the longest-running models in the automotive world, with the F-Series dating back all the way to 1948. The 2019 Ford F-150 has some heavy competition from brand new Ram and GM full-size pickups, but that hasn't slowed things down for Ford. Even as the F-150 ages, it hasn't been fully redesigned since 2015, we still find it to be a fantastic choice for those in the truck market. What's new for 2019? Changes are minor for the 2019 F-150, but there are a couple of note. The Raptor engine has been made available in the maximum luxury limited trim. That means you can now have 450 horsepower and 510 pound-feet of torque in an F-150 that isn't an off-road beast. The F-150 XLT trim also adds SYNC 3 to the list of standard equipment, which means it gets the 8-inch touchscreen now. What's the F-150's interior and in-car technology like? The 2019 Ford F-150 interior ranges broadly in materials and technology throughout the many trims. Straight lines and angles remain all the way to the expensive limited trim, the styling truly captures the truck persona. All the big buttons, switches and simple layout look and feel proper on the truck, and there aren't any weird interior gimmicks. Each trim level improves on the one below it, ranging from rubber floor mats and vinyl seats to thick carpet, real wood and leather covering everything. There are even three high luxury trims in the King Ranch, Platinum, and Limited, which really just differ in the fanciness and look of their interior materials and in how much equipment is standard. Ford can't match the Ram's optional 12-inch screen, but it has a responsive 8-inch touchscreen, running the SYNC 3 tech interface that supports both Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. SYNC 3 works well enough, and is probably one of the simpler and cleaner infotainment interfaces out there. If you plan on towing, then you'll enjoy the F-150's trailer backup assist that allows you to travel and reverse with the trailer through a simple knob interface on the dash. No more figuring out which way to counterintuitively turn the steering wheel. How big is the F-150? Ford makes the F-150 in three body styles, regular cab, super cab and super crew. The Super Cab with an 8-foot bed is the longest F-150 you can buy, measuring it at 250.5 inches. You'll be sacrificing interior space that way, as in other extended cabs, the back seat's cramped legroom and upright backrest is best suited for occasional short trips. The F-150 Super Cab also utilizes annoying clamshell doors rather than the regular front hinged doors found on rival trucks with similar length cabs. The Super Crew does have regular doors and obviously provides the most interior room. Nobody will be wanting for more legroom or just space in general, just like every other full-size pickup sold today. It's very comfortable back there, although unlike the Ram and Toyota Tundra, the seat back doesn't recline. Seating for either 5 or 6 is available with either the Super Cab and Super Crew. The interior feels like it has a lot of space and tons of headroom. There are multiple levels to easily rest your left arm, and the seats do not lack in room to spread out and get comfortable. The bed is a choose-your-own-adventure type story. A full 8-foot bed is available on both the regular cab and super cab, but the 6.5-foot bed is the largest you can option on the Super Crew. Ford also boasts the distinctive tailgate assist step, derisively dubbed the man step in GM advertisements, which makes getting up and down from the bed an exponentially easier experience, especially if doing so repeatedly. What's the F-150's performance and fuel economy? There are many variations when it comes to powertrain setups on the F-150. The Bass engine is a 3.3-liter V6 that makes 290 horsepower and 265 pound-feet of torque. Then Ford offers a pair of turbocharged V6s as upgrades. First is the 2.7-liter EcoBoost V6, outputting 325 horsepower and 400 pounds-feet of torque. Upgrade from that and you get the 3.5-liter EcoBoost that produces 375 horsepower and 470 pounds-feet of torque. If you buy the Raptor or Limited, you get the high-output 3.5-liter V6 and it's whopping 450 horsepower and 510 pounds-feet of torque. Ford still offers the 5.0-liter V8 as an engine upgrade for the 2019 model year, so truck fans can still go for displacement over everything else. There's also the 3.0-liter V6 turbodiesel option. This oil burner makes 250 horsepower and 440 pound-feet of torque. Every engine is paired with a 10-speed automatic transmission except for the entry-level V6, which is mated to a 6-speed auto. Fuel economy varies by style, so we'll break it out for you here with some ranges. 3.3-liter V6, between 17 to 20 miles per gallon in the city and 22 to 25 miles per gallon on the highway. 2.7-liter EcoBoost V6, 18 to 20 miles per gallon city and 23 to 26 miles per gallon highway. 3.5-liter EcoBoost V6, 15 to 18 miles per gallon city, 18 to 25 miles per gallon highway. 5.0-liter V8, 15 to 17 miles per gallon city, and 19 to 23 miles per gallon highway. 3.0-liter V6 diesel, 20 to 22 miles per gallon city, and 25 to 30 miles per gallon highway. Towing and payload ratings also vary widely, but the maximum towing capacity is 13,200 pounds, while payload tops out at 3,270 pounds. What's the F-150 like to drive? The answer to this question changes drastically depending on which F-150 you buy. It could be slow and boring with a 3.3-liter V6 work truck, or Baja racer-like with the F-150 Raptor. The ride and handling have been consistently praised since it was last redesigned for 2015. That said, its slow steering is a bit more traditionally truckish than what's in the Ram and especially the Chevrolet Silverado. The ride quality also isn't quite as smooth and controlled as the Ram, which has a class-leading ride, while the available 22-inch wheels make the ride intolerably jarring. The F-150's 10-speed automatic shines, downshifting smartly without drawing much attention to itself. The HOV6 Raptor engine is a real standout. It has a profound acceleration advantage over the most powerful Ram 1500. Moving well beyond capability into the realm of indulgence. It pairs the smooth, effortless, low-end power of the lesser 3.5-liter turbo V6 found in other F-150s with an even greater wallop of thrust and a wicked snarl from the unique dual exhaust that never gets old. In the diesel truck, the power stroke is a real peach. If you didn't know it had a diesel, from behind the wheel it feels just like a torquey gasoline engine. Power comes on smooth and low, only falling off slightly towards the top of the rev range. You're never wanting for power, be it passing on a two-lane road or climbing up a steep mountain pass. Just note that its payload isn't quite as high most of the gas engines, and its fuel economy may not be enough to counter its hefty price premium.
Audio Jungle.